Hi everyone. Today we are going to see the properties of electromagnetic waves. Last class we studied a few common properties of electromagnetic waves. I will repeat that once again. First one, it does not require any medium for its propagation. Second one, all the entire electromagnetic spectrum travels with a speed of light, that is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second in vacuum and 2 × 10⁸ meter per second in water. And the third point, what all the properties shown by light rays. Likewise, the entire electromagnetic spectrum also shows the common properties like reflection and refraction. And the next point is, it is not affected by the electric field or magnetic field. And the last one, the entire electromagnetic waves are traveling like transverse waves. So these are the common properties of entire electromagnetic spectrum. Now let us see each and every electromagnetic rays particularly. What is the special properties of each and every rays separately? Like what is the source, what is the properties, how it can be detected, what is the use of each rays. Okay. And our first one, we are going to study in the range of increasing wavelength. So we are starting with the first ray which is having least wavelength, that is of gamma rays. And gamma rays is coming under the range of, as in the case of wavelength, it is coming under the range of less than 0.01 nanometer. Or we can represent this in terms of angstrom. I hope you know what is nanometer and angstrom. Nanometer means 10⁻⁹ and angstrom means 10⁻⁹. So this gamma ray is coming under the range of less than 0.01 nanometer. And what is the source of this gamma rays? Actually, these gamma rays are produced during the radioactive disintegration of elements. Any element which is having the atomic number greater than 82 is mostly come under the category of radioactive elements. So when during this disintegration time, it emit energy. So gamma ray is also one among that, and even we can see in cosmic rays also. So these are the sources of gamma rays. Now what are the properties of gamma rays? So gamma rays shows fluorescence in zinc sulfide. You know what is fluorescence? So it shows zinc fluorescence in zinc sulfide. And the most important property of the gamma ray is that it has an ability to penetrate through the metal. It has an ability to penetrate through a thick metal, and even it can penetrate through the human body. So we are using that property to do one use. That means we are using it for radiotherapy. Radiotherapy means killing of cancerous cells. So there we are utilizing that property to penetrate through the human body, and we can kill the cancerous cells. So these are the properties, source and use of gamma rays. After gamma ray, we have X-rays. Actually, X-rays are produced when heavy metals which have high melting point is heat by cathode rays. Cathode ray tube that we were using in olden days, in olden picture tube. So when the cathode rays or electron beam hit on a high melting point metal, we used to get the X-rays. And it is having a range, wavelength range of 0.01 nanometer to 10 nanometer. So this cathode ray is the source of X-rays. And if you see the properties, you can see that it also shows the fluorescence in zinc sulfide and is affected by the photographic plate. And another property is that it will penetrate only through the human flesh. For the X-ray, for the gamma ray, we saw that it can penetrate through the human entire body. But when we come to the case of X-ray, it can only penetrate through the human flesh and it is stored by the bones. So we are utilizing that application to take the X-ray or the photo of our fractured bones, if you are getting any fracture or anything. So we are using, doctors used to suggest for taking X-ray. So what they are doing is that they will allow the X-rays to pass through our body. So it will penetrate through our body flesh. And where the bones are there, it will be stored and we will get the clear picture whether we have fracture or any other thing. And another one, we are using this one in the medical field for CT scanning. Okay, for there also we are using the help of X-rays. And to find out or study the atomic arrangement or atomic structure, in that case industrial field or in chemical field also, we are using the application of X-rays. And in some industries, we are using the X-rays to check the welding, whether any mistake is there during the welding and all. There also, we are using the application of X-rays. So, these are the source, properties and uses of X-rays. This is the second least wavelength ray. Okay, our next important ray is ultraviolet rays. It's having a wavelength of 10 nanometer to 400 nanometer. And it is found by a scientist named J. Richter in 1801. So in this ultraviolet rays, first we are going to see how can we detect the presence of ultraviolet radiation. We have three different methods to detect the presence of ultraviolet radiation. First one, we have to take a silver chloride solution and we have to allow the entire electromagnetic spectrum to pass through. And it should be from red end to violet end. So we can see that beyond the violet end, slowly the silver chloride solution changes into violet and later it will become dark brown. So that shows the presence of ultraviolet radiation in the electromagnetic spectrum. When we see the next case, or the second case, it shows more chemical activity on dyes and photographic plate. That's the second method of detection of ultraviolet rays. And the third method, is when we allow this white light or the entire electromagnetic spectrum through the quartz prism, it also shows the ultraviolet radiation. When we allow it to pass through a normal glass prism, what happens is that it will absorb other than the visible rays. So other rays are not visible through that. So but if you are instead of glass prism, if we are using the quartz prism, we can see the presence of ultraviolet radiation. And after that, if you see the source of ultraviolet radiation, we know that the most important source of ultraviolet radiation is our sun. And the second one, even the electric arc and the spark also will produce the electromagnetic spectrum. And we are very familiar with the mercury vapor lamp. That also is a source of ultraviolet radiation. And if you see the harmful effect, we know that always doctors and everywhere they used to tell that don't be too exposed to the sun. We know that nowadays the ozone layer is depleting and more ultraviolet rays is coming into the earth. So if you are being more under the sunlight, there's a chance for skin cancer. So actually this ultraviolet radiation is the reason for skin cancer. If we see the properties and use of ultraviolet radiation, we can see the common properties, like what are the properties we studied for the electromagnetic rays, like it does not want any media for its propagation, it also shows refraction and reflection, it won't be affected by the electric and magnetic field, it's also a transverse wave, and we can detect through the quartz prism, and we are using it for it shows the chemical activity or it shows the fluorescence, it will be affected by the photographic plate. All these things are coming under the property of ultraviolet radiation. If you see the use of ultraviolet radiation, mainly we are using this ultraviolet radiation or UV rays for three purposes. First one, sterilizing purpose. We know that in especially during this corona time, everyone need more sterilized objects, whatever it is, even the mask, gloves and all the equipments used by most of the people should be sterilized. So there we are in, especially in hospitals, for sterilizing purpose, the doctors and the team is always using the ultraviolet radiation. So they have to keep it into a solution. All the things should be sterilized and they have to allow the ultraviolet radiation to pass through. So automatically the entire system or entire equipment without touching, it will be sterilized. So they can use it for the further purpose. And next one, if you want to find out the purity of gems. Gems, you know, especially the girls know about the gems. We have different varieties of gems, ornaments. We used to make it for ornaments. So if you want to find out the purity of the gems, there also we are using the application of ultraviolet rays and even the eggs. almost everyone will like to have the eggs, no? So there also we are using the application to find out the purity of gems and even the eggs. We are using the ultraviolet radiations. And the last one, even in plants and animals, the production of vitamin D is also is from the ultraviolet radiation. So these are the main points comes under the ultraviolet radiation. First one, detection. We have three different methods to detect it. Then the sources, harmful if it was harmful, and the uses and even the properties. These are the main things we have to consider when in the case of ultraviolet radiation. After the UV rays, we have visible rays. This is very familiar to everyone. And even we saw the different spectrum of colors, the band of spectrum of colors in last class. And the range of wavelength starting from 400 nanometer to 800 nanometer. And we know that it is found by Sir Isaac Newton when he was doing some other experiment. And it's starting from violet end to red end. The wavelength of violet is 400 nanometer. And when we go to the last end of red light, we will get it as 800 nanometer. And if you think about the source of visible rays, we know that the ultimate source is sun. Even the electric bulb, what we have in our home, the torch light, the flames, everything is the source of visible light. And what is the use of visible light? It gives the vision to the entire animal kingdom, for even the animals and even for the human beings. So without this light or without this visible rays, we are not able to see anything in this world. So it's very, very important for us. That is the main application of this visible rays. And we are very, all of the, you are very much fond of photography. So in photography also, we need the presence of visible light. That's the second application of visible rays. And another important application of visible rays is that we need to have food. Especially we used to get food from the plants. Plants used to make food for us, right? So plants, for preparing the food during the process of photosynthesis, they also require the presence of visible light. So these are the main source, application and use of visible rays. Our next ray is infrared radiation. It's starting with the wavelength of 800 nanometer to 1 millimeter. And it is actually found by scientist William Herschel. And as in the case of like how we studied about the ultraviolet rays, same way infrared radiation is also one of the very important electromagnetic radiation. So here also we have to study how can we detect the presence of infrared radiation. For that we should have a thermometer with blackened bulb. And allow, we have to take the thermometer through the electromagnetic spectrum from violet end to red end. So during this time we can see a normal variation or normal rise in the temperature. When it closes the red end or beyond the red end, we can see a sudden increase in the temperature in the thermometer. So it shows the presence of infrared radiation of electromagnetic spectrum. And the another method is by using a thermopile. It's an electronic equipment which is using to convert the heat energy into electrical energy. So with the presence of that also along with thermopile, if we arrange a galvanometer setup, when we allow the electromagnetic spectrum to pass through that, we know that infrared radiation is having hot rays, so we used to call it as hot rays. So when these hot rays are passing over there, automatically that heat energy will be converted into electrical energy, and we know the purpose of galvanometer. Galvanometer means it shows the presence of electric current. So when this conversion is happening, this galvanometer shows a fast diffraction or the presence of electricity. So by that way also we can detect the presence of infrared radiation. Same way, if we allow the electromagnetic spectrum to pass through the glass prism, other than the visible rays, the rest of the rays will be absorbed by the glass prism. Instead of glass prism, if we are using the Roxar prism, only it will shows the infrared radiation. So by using the Roxar prism also, we can find or detect the presence of infrared radiation. If you see the source of infrared radiation, most of the red hot objects or hot materials are showing the presence of or being the source of infrared radiation. And if you see the properties of infrared radiation, we can use the common properties, whatever the things we studied as the case of entire electromagnetic spectrum. And other than that, some special properties are there. It is least affected by the photoelectric plate. And it is the least scattered rays. it is the least scattered rays because it's having a high wavelength. It's the least scattered rays in the electromagnetic spectrum. And when it passes through the rock salt prism, we can detect the presence of infrared radiation. And the harmful effect, if you see the harmful effect of infrared radiation, it causes skin burns. It causes skin burns. Now, in our daily life situation, if you see the uses of infrared radiation, we have loads of applications with the infrared radiation. The main thing we are using in our remote control, TV remote control and other gadgets, we are using this one. And for the signaling purpose, we are using this for signaling purpose, especially in the war time. So, from long distance, we can use infrared radiation and the co-soldiers can watch, and by that way, they can give the signal to the other people. And in darkroom setup, while developing the photography, in darkroom setup, we are using the infrared radiation. And we know that in all of the mobiles and cameras, we have a night mode photography. We can take the photos during the night time. There also we are using the application of infrared radiation. So these are the common application of infrared radiation during our day-to-day life. So this is about the infrared radiation detection, source, properties, the harmful effect and the uses. After IR radiation, we have microwave, and the range of wavelength is from 1 millimeter to 10 meter. And the main source of microwave is crystal oscillator, electronic gadgets like a crystal oscillator. And if you see the uses of microwave, mostly we are using it for satellite communication, radar communication, and we know that for cooking purpose, we are using in microwave ovens and to analyze the structure of atoms. So these are the main purpose or main uses of microwaves. Now we saw the entire electromagnetic spectrum, starting from gamma rays, X-rays, UV rays, visible rays, infrared rays, microwave and even radio waves. And we study the different sources, different the way how to detect it, what are the harmful effects, what are the application of all the rays. So in all the cases, along with these special properties and special conditions, we can utilize or we can write the properties what we studied common for the entire electromagnetic spectrum. Thank you.